Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening, welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Shreyasa Vijay. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 30th of December. India says no breakthrough in talks with China on border standoff. Pakistan's former foreign minister Khwaja Asif arrested on corruption charges. And Taliban behind recent targeted killings, claims Afghan Interior Minister. And now for all the details. India's Defence Minister Rajnath Singh on Wednesday said that talks between India and China have yet to make headway to end a standoff on the line of actual control in Ladakh, as thousands of troops from both sides face a freezing winter in Himalayan region. He, however, said both sides were still exchanging messages over the border situation and another round of military talks was in the offing.
India's Defence Minister Rajnath Singh on Wednesday said that no meaningful solution has come out of diplomatic and military level talks with China to resolve the standoff on the line of actual control, or LAC, in eastern Ladakh and their status quo. In an exclusive interview with news agency ANI, the defence minister said that if status quo continues, there cannot be a reduction in the deployment of troops. Rajnath Singh referred to the working mechanism for consultation and coordination meeting on India-China border affairs held virtually earlier this month and said the next round of military talks can take place anytime, as hotline messages have been exchanged.
अगले राउंड की भी बैठक होगी क्योंकि हाल में ही अभी WMCC यानी डिप्लोमेटिक लेवल पर बातचीत दोनों देशों के बीच हुई है लेकिन मिलिट्री लेवल पर बातचीत अगले राउंड में होने वाली है वो कभी भी हो सकती है लेकिन अभी तक कोई सार्थक परिणाम नहीं निकला है स्टेटस को बना हुआ है नहीं यथास्थिति बनी हुई है
India-China border tensions erupted and escalated after 20 Indian soldiers died in a violent standoff with the Chinese troops in Ladakh's Galwan Valley in June this year. Both sides have ramped up their military presence in recent months, moving men, weapons and supplies to the high-altitude, cold desert region.
Farmers' protest against new farm laws entered the 35th day on Wednesday as the sixth round of talks between the government and representative of protesting farmers resumed to resolve the impasse.
The farmers' protest against three agricultural laws that liberalize agriculture sector entered the 35th day, while talks between the representatives of the protesting farmers and the Indian government resumed on Wednesday afternoon to end the month-long deadlock. Leaders of around 40 farmer unions took part in the sixth round of discussions with India's Agriculture Minister Narendra Singh Tomar and Commerce and Industry Minister Piyush Goyal on Wednesday. During the meeting, farmer leaders once again reiterated their demand for repeal of the three farm laws, which they fear will leave them at the mercy of private players and stop the government from buying their produce at guaranteed prices. They also demanded justice and compensation for the families of the farmers who have died during the ongoing protests at Delhi's borders. Thousands of farmers have been camping out against the legislation at borders of Indian capital New Delhi since late November. The government has offered amendments but said it won't repeal the laws, arguing that farmers will gain if large traders, retailers and food processors can buy directly from them, bypassing antiquated wholesale markets.
Moving on, cold wave conditions intensified across North India on Tuesday, with fresh snowfall reported from hilly areas. Residents in Indian capital New Delhi were seen wearing multiple layers of clothes and sitting around bonfires to beat the chill as minimum temperature dropped to 3.5 degrees Celsius early in the morning.
Indian capital New Delhi witnessed extreme cold wave conditions aggravated by chilly winds and dense fog across the city on Tuesday. People sipped hot tea and were seen sitting around bonfires to save themselves from the chill. Earlier this week, the India Meteorological Department had warned of severe cold wave conditions across North India and also advised people to not consume alcohol during New Year's party or otherwise, saying that it reduces body temperature.
आज ठंड कुछ ज्यादा ही ठंड है, हवा तेज चल रही है, सुबह से काफी ज्यादा ठंड हो रही है, हाथ पे ठुठर रहे।
इसी ठंड में किस तरह की परेशानी?
परेशानी शरीर में दर्द होता है और ठंड काफी लगती है।
Snowfall in India's Jammu and Kashmir and Himachal Pradesh has a direct impact in parts of northern India, including Punjab, Haryana, Delhi and Uttar Pradesh. South Asia's winters are not as cold as other regions such as North America, but the drop in temperature has a devastating effect on the hundreds of thousands of homeless people.
The United States Attorney General Jeffrey Rosen said on Tuesday that Washington stands ready to try Ahmed Omar Saeed Sheikh, the alleged mastermind behind 2002 killing of American journalist Daniel Pearl in a U.S. court. The statement came after a Pakistani court ordered Al-Qaeda leader's release last week.
The United States may seek to try Ahmed Omar Saeed Sheikh in a U.S. court who is accused of killing American journalist Daniel Pearl after a Pakistani court ordered his release, Acting Attorney General Jeffrey Rosen said on Tuesday. Last week, Pakistan's Sindh High Court ordered the release of Al-Qaeda leader Sheikh, the main suspect in the 2002 kidnapping and murder of Pearl, a Wall Street Journal reporter, after his conviction was overturned. The court said the charges against him were null and void. Rosen, in a statement, said the separate judicial rulings reversing his conviction and ordering his release are an affront to terrorism victims everywhere. If efforts to reinstate Sheikh's conviction were not successful, the United States stands ready to take custody of Omar Sheikh to stand trial. 38-year-old Daniel Pearl was the South Asia bureau chief for the Wall Street Journal when he was abducted and beheaded while he was in Pakistan, investigating a story in 2002 on the links between the country's powerful spy agency ISI and Al-Qaeda.
More on news from Pakistan. The National Accountability Bureau, or NAB, obtained transit remand of Pakistan's former foreign minister and PMLN leader Khwaja Asif from an Islamabad accountability court on Wednesday, after which a team of officials took him to Lahore. Asif was arrested by the NAB on Tuesday night for allegedly having assets beyond means of income. Asif has called his arrest an attempt to weaken his party chief Nawaz Sharif. PMLN chief and former premier Nawaz Sharif has also condemned the arrest by calling it a joke. Slamming incumbent Prime Minister Imran Khan's Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf government, Nawaz Sharif on Tuesday said the arrest shows the desperation of the government. The arrest comes at a time when the Pakistan Democratic Movement, an alliance of 11 opposition parties, is expected to organize protest rallies across Pakistan next month to demand Imran Khan's resignation. In news from Afghanistan, Afghanistan's Interior Minister Masood Andarabi has said the Taliban is behind the targeted killings and that the attacks in the country have increased since the US-Taliban agreement, which was signed in February this year. Andarabi asserted the Taliban had major plans to overrun more areas in the several provinces, but they were prevented, causing the group to focus on targeted killings in Kabul.
Afghanistan's Interior Minister Masood Andarabi has said the Taliban is behind the targeted killings and that the attacks in the country have increased since the US-Taliban agreement, which was signed in February this year. While speaking to the Afghan Senate about the security situation in Afghanistan and particularly in Kabul, on Tuesday, Andarabi said the Taliban had major plans to overrun more areas in the provinces, including Helmand, but they were prevented, causing the group to focus on targeted killings in Kabul. The remarks by the Interior Minister came as President Ashraf Ghani earlier this week also raised concern over the attacks on journalists and civil society activists and said these are attempts to destabilize the country and demoralize its new generation. Afghanistan continues to be hit by violence even as the Afghan government and the insurgent Taliban have been holding meetings since September to discuss an end to the 19-year war. There has been a rising number of killings by small magnetic bombs placed under vehicles in recent weeks, mostly in the capital Kabul, many blamed on the Taliban.
Moving on to news from Nepal. Amid rising rift within Nepal's ruling Nepal Communist Party, rival faction led by co-chair Pushp Kamal Dahal hit the streets in a show of power on Tuesday while expressing objection over Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli's recent move to dissolve the parliament. The demonstrators, who called Oli's move unconstitutional, rallied outside Oli's office despite coronavirus curbs on gatherings.
Hundreds of opponents of Nepal's Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli marched through the streets of Kathmandu on Tuesday, urging him to withdraw his decision to dissolve parliament and call for early elections. The protesters, including Nepal Communist Party or NCP co-chair Pushp Kamal Dahal and other senior leaders who say Oli's decision on December 20 was unconstitutional, rallied outside Oli's office despite coronavirus curbs on gatherings. Oli, who is also the co-chair of NCP, says internal squabbling and a lack of cooperation from his party have paralyzed decision-making, forcing him to seek a fresh popular mandate.
यो आन्दोलन प्रतिनिधि सभा हाम्रो केपी सम्माननीय प्रधानमन्त्री ज्यू केपी शर्मा ओली ज्यूले प्रतिनिधि सभा विघटन गरेको विषयमा हो यो आन्दोलन म यो प्रतिनिधि सभा विघटन प्रति म घोर विरोध गर्दछु
राष्ट्रपति र प्रधानमन्त्री दुई जना एकलले चाहिँ यो जुन संसद विघटन गरेकोमा नेपाली जनता आक्रोशित पनि छन् र यो 5 वर्षको म्यान्डेट दिएका नेपाली जनताले 5 वर्षको म्यान्डेटमा गर्दछ संविधान विपरीत
This comes as with rising rift inside the ruling NCP between the factions led by PM Oli and co-chair Pushp Kamal Dahal. The party is on the brink of split.
For the first time, the Indo-Tibetan Border Police or ITBP's dog squad caught Indian names instead of traditional Western names, after a formal naming ceremony of 17 pups was held at the National Training Center for Dogs in northern Haryana state on Wednesday. By naming the little canine soldiers with Indian names, that too from the areas guarded by the ITBP, the force aims to give respect to all the troops guarding the tough borders of India.
The Indo-Tibetan Border Police or ITBP's dog squad got Indian names instead of the traditional Western names for the first time on Wednesday as a formal naming ceremony was held at the National Training Center for Dogs in Panchkula city of India's Haryana province. The 17 pups were named after the areas guarded by the ITBP as a respect of all the troops guarding the tough borders of the country. The force now plans that the next batch of pups will be named after other prominent names of the icy frontiers where ITBP is deployed, covering the entire border from Karakoram to Jechapla, guarded by the elite mountain crack outfit.
These 17 pups have been bred and reared at the National Training Center for Dogs, ITBP BTC Bhanu, and this is a special Namkaran ceremony that we have organized, and we have named our dogs against the on the places of our deployment as a crisp salute to our troops that are deployed in blood freezing, bone numbing, high altitude terrain.
The ITBP has received requests from other Central Armed Police Forces for the pups to be used for their security duties. ITBP was the first force to deploy Malinois dogs in left-wing extremism or LWE hit areas a decade ago. And now they have also started scientifically breeding canines to meet on demands and provide pups to other forces as mandated by the Ministry of Home Affairs.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/SAsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter at SAsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.